So the next homework, let's work together. So the homework for adding the getters, setters for the class city and etc. So what I'm gonna do first, I'm gonna open the idea. Opening that, I'm gonna find my project. So if you have that already open, that's fine. So I'm gonna open my project, the one that I worked with before. If you cannot find it, feel free to create a new project. If you work with Git, it's perfect. Just create a new branch and start working with that. Okay, so over here I have homework number one. So I'm gonna add another folder. It's actually not a folder, it's a package. That's the terminology from Java. Homework 2. Okay, so it seems like it's kind of a next lesson. So it's asking us to get us to add the getters and setters to the class city. So let's do the same. So let's add the class city, and let's add the add the main class, so that we have kind of the same structure of classes as it was before. For the main, I'm gonna add a public static void main method, and for the class, I'm gonna have what was that? Not for the class. Oh my god, that was city, right? I'm gonna rename it. I'm gonna click right button. Oops. I'm gonna click right button, refactor and rename. Sorry. City. Okay, refactor. Perfect. It's taking some time. Okay, so now it's not a class, it's just a city. A city class. Not a class, it's a city class now. Okay, so it used to have a string city name, and it used to have int population. Both of them used to be private. So private for the city name and private for the population. Okay, perfect. And also the city used to have a constructor. Actually, let me, instead of typing manually, I'm gonna click on one of the properties, generate and constructor. And you also kind of could see that there was also a getters and setters to generate. So I am a lazy person, so let me actually do the same. So right button on any of these two, not here, not here, not here, not here, but on the name of the property file, right button, generate getters and setters. So you select that getters and setters, or you can select just getters or just setters. I will get both. And I want to select more than one, so I'll need to click shift, click and hold it, and then select two, or if you have more properties, you can select more. And I'm gonna click OK. So and automatically, as you can see, IntelliJ IDEA created me that methods, getters and setters. All of them are public. The properties are private. That's perfect. That's a good approach. Okay, so let's take a look what else do we need to do here. So that's the first one. I created the getters and setters for the city. In main, create a new object of the city and set its name to Mexico. Set population value as well. Okay, cool. Let's do that. So I'm gonna open my main. I'm gonna add the indention 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. I added the indention basically. Then over here, I want to create the object of the city class. So I'm writing the city. Then some city x equals new city. And then over here, I want to add to specify some of the properties. But here is the thing. Here is the thing. I'm gonna remove for the getters and setters. It's cool. Actually, yeah, the idea of this homework is actually to show you how you can use getters and setters. So you can either do the initialization of the properties for the cities through the constructor or through the setters. Okay? Setters would set the value, or in constructor you can set a value once and then never set it again. So in our station, I think that's exactly what we need. I think I'm gonna remove the setters, and you will see the power of this getter setters and why it is so important. Okay, so for the city, I'm gonna name my city San Diego, and then population 3 million. Okay, 3 million. And then, as you can see, it's all gonna be set. So now I want to do the system out println, and I want to print some of the values, some city x dot, and then you see setters are not valid because we removed that setters. So we have get city name, okay, and I'm gonna do plus space plus some city x. Some cdx dot get population. So in this way, I will never be able to set a new value in the city. So after I done the initialization, the line number 5, let me fix this one. So after done the initialization for the city on the line number 5, I will never be able to set the name of the city again. If I need that in the future, I can in the future add the setter for the city name. So let me do that. Public void, because setters is not returning anything. Set city name, okay. Then string string name, okay. Then body, and then I will write the this dot city name equals name, okay. So then in my main, I can reset the city name to something else. So some city x set city name Orlando, for example. And I'm gonna call the same method again, the same print out again. And you will see that the first line will be San Diego 3 million. And then the second line will be Orlando and 3 million. So, because I changed the name of the city on this line. Let me run it. So you can, oops. So I did messed up something. So I'll do the command Z. Okay, looks good. Is it executing or not? Yes, it's building something for me. Compile fail, yeah, because I messed up some things. So let me click again, run. It's executing over here, it's executing over here. Okay, doing some stuff. I'm gonna get some drink. It's actually coffee, guys, no worries. Yeah, let's see. So you see San Diego, Orlando, and you can set some for something else. You can add a setter for population, and so on and so on. So that's the power of getters and setters, right? So sometimes it really makes sense not to add the setters. Sometimes it really makes sense to add the setters. Also, constructor is optional. You can remove this construction and just use setters. Okay. Of course, you can make this one public, and you can also set the value to the city directly, like the sum city dot city name equals I don't know, Chicago, for example. It's possible to do like this, but it is bad approach. It is. I will copy this line 8, and you will see that it will work exactly the same. So with the line 9, it's the same idea, more direct without any methods setting, but you know, it's not kind of good approach opening the properties with the public. And by the way, I don't like having this empty lines at the end, so I'll remove this empty two lines. So okay, so you see Chicago 3 million as well, so I was able to reset, but for that I had to make it public. I don't like it, so I will remove these two lines and we'll move it back the name of the city as private. Okay, so this is the best approach, keeping the private for the properties. Okay, let's take a look what else do we have for the homework. Okay, make a call. Okay, create a new object CD and set its name. Okay, print these values on the CD object using getter method to access values. Okay, I did that. Add two different parameter constructor in the city class. Okay, let's add another constructor. Okay, I can actually add different, I don't know, maybe some value and maybe the string, the country name. Okay. And we can add also a property for the country, private string country. Okay, and I'll add that country, this dot country equals country name. Okay, so as you can see, this constructor is gray because it's not used yet. This one is not gray, it's used. So let's see the homework. So add two different parameterized constructors. Okay, I edit. In the main, create two new objects of the city using constructors created, like in the step number two and step number four, print values of the object created in five. So basically now I have another constructor of the same class. So now I can actually create a city. Let's do some city Y equals new city. And over here I may use one of the constructors. Oops. So I wanna type, for example, San Diego. Okay, then population. And then if I use the third parameter, then I will call another new constructor. So I will use USA, and I'm gonna use call this new constructor. Yeah, see this one is too big for integer, so I'll remove extra zero, because integer is limited. It cannot like keep like million. So let's let me print the same city and the population. Actually, let me change that San Diego to something else. Los Angeles. Okay. So the Los Angeles and the country. For the country, I don't have getter. So as you can see, the country is private. So let me click on that. Generate and getter. Okay. Okay, so now I have this getter. I want to remove this method to all these getters and setters so that I have everything nice and organized. So all these properties together, all these getters and setters together, and constructors also together. So, and let me also add plus some city, actually Y. You see, I forgot to change it to Y. If you do the same, if you forgot to change it to Y, like to name of this object, then what is gonna print for you? It's gonna print for you Orlando, right? But you want to use with the same object. And when I click twice, you see that little highlights me with a little green color. Okay, I'm gonna click dot and get a country. Okay, so for this object, the country will be equal to null. So let me prove that. I'm gonna add this breakpoint over here. I'm gonna debug it. If you never set the country for this object, right? However, we created another object that is calling another constructor and sets the country to the USA, and then in the print you will see the country. Okay, so let me show you. So yeah, as you can see, this is some city X. I'm gonna click on that, and you see country null, population 3 million, Orlando. Okay, I'm gonna do the step over. Okay, I have nothing changed. It's just in console I have printed everything. So I'm gonna do the step over. So here we created another object, right? And in the debugger, you're gonna see this objects X and Y. You know, Y, it's already initialized everything, the city name, population, and country. And you see, now I'm gonna print it out. I'm gonna do this line, and it shows me Los Angeles, 330 million USA. So yeah, I forgot to add here the empty space. That's why it's together. But that's it, I think, for the homework. For the homework, we printed values of both objects, and we even debugged everything. So let me finish that. Cool. Thank you, guys. Hope you like that.